And XX, how you guys doing? Welcome back to another vloggity vlog. Welcome to another vlog. If this is your first time stopping by on my channel, stopping by, it's my channel road. I haven't been able to actually vlog this week. I'm starting out this video on a Wednesday instead of my usual Mondays or Sundays. I lost the patient on my call on Monday and that actually broke me into many pieces. I've come to the conclusion that I hate calls. Okay, not just that I hate calls, I hate calls in surgery because I think I've explained this in one of my vlogs where I told you guys, I think it's my neurosurgery rotation, when I told you guys that if the surgical unit that you're in doesn't do unit calls, you're going to do like a general surgery department call. So you're going to be covering for all units that don't do unit calls. I don't like that, or I don't like the idea of that, because you are going to be called for patients you have zero clue about. Like, you don't know this patient from Adam. And the truth is that you can't know every single patient. You're just supposed to know very well, like in total, what patients in your unit. And I mean, pediatric surgery, I don't know anything about adults in the hospital. Do you understand? And whenever you're called, well, except it's to recite a line, an IV line, and maybe to give certain medications that the nurses wouldn't give. There are some medications that we give as house officers. Typically, the nurses give most of the medications, but then there are some medications that we give as house officers, especially medications that you need to monitor, you need to be careful, you need to look out for side effects and things like that. So aside these two, when you're called for like an emergency for a patient in the world, I know you can know like the general thing to do. Oh, if a person needs CPR, obviously you know he has to institute CPR. But then again, you don't really know this person that, or you know what they are treating them for. You know, okay, what might have caused this. And it's not, if it's an emergency, it's not the time to start looking through the system and find, oh, what is this person being treated for? And that, I don't like that fact. I like to know my patients. I like to know what's up with them. I like to know what to do when, you know, something happens. What if it's a complication of the disease process that is going on and I have no clue or no idea about? That's why I have come to the conclusion that I don't like general surgery calls. Like, when I say general surgery, I don't mean general surgery like the unit. I mean general surgery like surgery team on call, covering for every other unit. And then some things that I would honestly not like to talk about in this video, so let's just leave it at that. So that was the first patient that I lost all my, no, I have maybe lost a patient in pediatrics. Just one. It was bad. The condition of patient was critical. Even this one that I lost on my call was very critical, and nothing could have been done, but I still felt very bad. Why I felt very bad, or like it got to me, because that was actually the first one I had to like certify and sign and write, you know, like I had to call it. It was pretty sad. I'm gonna call tomorrow again. I'm on call tomorrow again, and let's hope for the best. My calls are actually never like crazy, but Monday particularly was actually very crazy. I think there were a lot of line setting. I was called multiple times. Like Monday was a crazy day, and then Tuesday, which was yesterday, was surgery. Oh, my bad. It's my fault. I did say that I am now in a new unit in surgery. I'm currently doing my pediatric surgery rotation, which is basically going to last for 2 weeks. So I started on Monday, and on Tuesday was our surgery day. That was yesterday, and it was right after my call. And we had like 6 surgeries done yesterday. It was a crazy day. 6 surgeries and 1 minor procedure. It was a crazy day. I got back to my house around 7. I left my house around 7 on Monday and got back 7 a.m. on Monday and got back to my house around 7 p.m. on Tuesday. When I came back, I couldn't even sleep. Like, sleep wasn't there. So I slept late, and then I woke up. See, yeah, today was, I didn't really care about a lot of things today. I wanted to not go to work. Like, I don't have that luxury. I honestly don't have that luxury to decide that, because there will be consequences of my action, literally. So today I actually came back late, or not really late, yeah, because that's actually close of work. I came back by the end of the day, like end of a work day, and I slept. Oh my god, I slept for like, what am I even saying? I slept. How am I stretching it? I just slept for 3 hours. But yeah, I slept, and I feel much lighter because I was having, my head was splitting. My head was banging. I was having headaches. Like, but anyway, I feel a whole lot much better. That English sounded so complex. I feel much better, you guys. I've done my skincare. Now I want to do a little bit of studying. I told myself I want to study every single day. I want to allocate a particular time studying every single day, because studying never stops. Don't let anybody lie to you, except you just want to be a one-kind doctor. Studying never stops. You have to remind yourself of things that you know. You have to acquire new knowledge. You have to change, like, maybe not change, like, you know, tweak some ideas that you had, or some like treatment options for certain disease conditions. The learning never stops in this profession, okay? Because you're dealing with human life, and new things happen every single time. Now, I'm not saying that you can't use what was already there before, but you can always, you know, mix things up. Anyway, I'm talking too much. I just came out here to introduce this vlog and rant a little bit about my week so far, past 2 weeks. Right now I want to study. I want to a little studying, because I actually want to sleep early today. I don't know what tomorrow holds. Tomorrow does not hold anything in the name of Jesus, but I do want to rest early today. Even though I've rested, I still want to rest again. So yeah, welcome to a new vlog, guys.
Hi guys, it's morning now. I am on my way to the hospital. I'm on call today, like I told you guys. So let's just do a bit of fit check before I leave. So guys, this is what I'm wearing. I'm sorry you can't have the full fit, but this is it. I'm wearing this sequin kind of top, my pants from Maka, and my Crocs, because I don't have the energy to carry, wear like a shoe and then carry my Crocs and then change when it's time for my, like, I don't have energy for all that. I'm running late. We have a lot of things to do. We have surgery, we have clinic, we have rounds. So I need to get going and do my own rounds before the actual round starts. So see you guys in the hospital. Starting today with the circumcision, but first things first, I have to get something to eat because I need food in my stomach, because after circumcision I'm going right straight to clinic. And then we're a bit more done with our rounds, just to document. Yeah, let me go get something to eat, like maybe a snack or something. Then I'll return back for the circumcision. Myself, some chi, active juice, and then some snacks inside here. Meat pie, donuts, and all that. Yep, breakfast. You guys, guess who just circumcised a baby? I just did my first circumcision ever. I just did my first, performed my first surgery. Okay, it's not really a surgery, it's more of a procedure. But I just did my first circumcision. I did all the cutting and I'm shaking inside me. I can't wait to assist in more surgeries and hopefully know how to perform. I assisted in one and I performed one. We had three circumcisions today. I observed, first of all, I assisted before I even observed. After assisting, I just observed the second one very closely and then I did the third one. I don't know how to act now. I don't know how to act. I need to change because I need to document and I also need to go to clinic. That's it, you guys. That is it. I'm super excited. I don't know how to act now because... Fun fact, you guys. I'm on call today. Oh, thankfully, they've changed our roster. I was on call on Monday. Now then Thursday, then Sunday, but they changed it, so I'm not called on Sunday anymore. I'm so excited. But anyway, that's not what I came here to rant about. I'm gonna call today and we have surgery, interception surgery by 4. That's laparotomy plus or minus, is this tomioscopy? Plus or minus bowel resection and anastomosis, depending on what we see when we go in there. This is like the second interception we're seeing this week. We did one surgery on Tuesday for interception. I wasn't able to see that one because I was running around for a patient. So hopefully I'll get to see today's home. It's going to happen later in the evening, like past work time. But anyway, I'm on call, so I'm excited. I won't really lose anything. I need to go and document for my patient that I just performed the surgery on. The minor procedure on, then I'll head to the clinic. I'm all changed. My trouser, what's it called? What's it just fell off, and I'm upset. Anyway, I would like to officially. I can't even keep it serious. I'd like to officially welcome you all to my consulting room. It's time to get to work, guys. I have some patients to raise bill for surgery and send their surgery pack for next week. So let me get to that before I actually start seeing patients. Right. Bye, guys. day. Right now, I'm just trying to do some mock-up, take some samples for some babies who are less than 2 years. If babies are less than 2 years, we take the samples. If they're more than two, if they're 2 years and above, we send them to the lab. So I have two samples to take from two babies, samples to take, because we have to book them for surgery, so we have to make sure that everything is fine before we go for surgery. Yeah. So I've also, what's the word I'm looking for? Yes, I have booked all the patients for surgery. I've given them dates. We are booked up until like next month. So right now what I want to do is I want to write the theater list for next week. Today's Thursday and typically we have our surgeries on Tuesday. So I need to make theater list for Tuesday so that I can submit it to the department so that it can be printed and circulated, all that good stuff. Anyway, let me get to work. I think that's the last. I just realized the time is 3:30 or 3:40 actually. Oh my god, time has disappeared. I finished taking the samples, by the way. And now I'm just going to make the theater list. That's pretty much it. And I'm done for the day. We still have the one emergency surgery shot pending, which we'll attend to. It's by 4. I've not eaten. I need to hurry up and eat something before it's time for surgery. I have been chasing results. Oh my lord. I've been chasing results for the patient that was supposed to do surgery on. We did a little bit of electrolyte correction this afternoon. So we had to, you know, take another sample to see if there have been any improvements. I'm a bit breathless. I had to go up, down, up again, down again. Just so I went up and down like 6 times now, right now. So I have to leave this room, go to the lab, come down from the lab, go upstairs to get my food, come downstairs, come back up again, and now I'm here. Anyway, long story. The result is not out yet, but hopefully in the next 10 minutes it should be out. So we will make a decision if we're going to operate this night or if it's something that we can wait till morning to do. We most likely, we may operate this night. I don't know what my chief is going to say. I need to eat now because, yeah, I need to eat now. I need all the energy I can get just in case we're going to be operating this night. I don't know why my face is glowing. I've been stressed, but I haven't really been feeling the stress because I've actually been enjoying myself. So, yeah, anyway, I just want to come and update you guys with like what's going on, what's happening. That's what's popping, guys. Call food today is swallow. It's semo and egusi. And for some reason, they gave us pomo or I don't even know what that's in, but it's not meat. And I know I'm not going to eat. And they put soup. Usually, they give us 2 meats, but I'm like, what's this? I don't like that. Anyway, let me eat now and, you know, keep my strength. In case if we don't operate today, we'll still operate tomorrow morning, so I still need my strength that way. So yeah guys, that's what's happening, that's what's popping. So guys, I got a consult from one of the wards, so now I have to go and check what the problem is and then call my chief if there's any need to. Let's go. Guys, it is, I'm not on my wristwatch. It's past 6 right now. I think it's almost 6:30 or so right now, and I haven't gone home. This is the next day, this Friday. If I haven't said that already at this point. I'm done for the day. I just took a very quick shower because my plan is that when I get home, I'm going to just collapse on my bed. And I started to order food. I bought food on Child Deck. Let me show you guys. This is supposed to be soya rice and chicken. Hold on guys, it's not very clear. This is soya rice and chicken. Hope I can see the chunks of soya and then the chicken. I got this on Child Deck. Actually, I got this from Korede Spaghetti and Child Deck delivered to me here. And I also bought juice, chivita, to just step down because I deserve it in here and now, because my plan is to sleep when I get home, and I want to have enough energy so that I don't sleep on my way home, I don't sleep on the journey home and just forget myself. So that's why I'm trying. I took my bath and just poured water on my body, and I'm eating now, so I'm not too fatigued to like go home. Do you understand? So yeah, hopefully I should get home before 7. It's getting dark really quickly, so let me just eat quickly and just go home. Hello people, sorry my laptop is getting in the way. What's popping? What's good? You guys, it's the weekend already, and I know I didn't speak to you guys on Friday when I came back. I told you guys I was going to, you know, collapse on my bed and just sleep. And I slept really well. But anyway, it's the weekend. I want to take out my braids. I have already cut them already. It's just to losing them. I typically would lose my take out my braids by myself. I don't go to a salon for this, but right now I want to go to a salon. I'm actually really stressed. My mirror is a little bit blurry. I kind of depleted my room. I don't know why I forgot to clean this mirror. But anyway, I need to go to the salon right now, like very soon, and just take out my braids. I also want to wash it. I want to see if I can also set it. Is that the word? Yes, I want to see if I can set it. But just before I leave, I want to script some videos that I will film when I get back, and some content, just general content. So yeah, I need to script my videos for YouTube and TikTok. I really want to have a productive week, like next week. I really want my week to be productive, so I need to be like on top of a lot of things. Hi guys, so I am back from the salon now. I ended up not doing what I wanted to do because by the time I went there, okay, so the plan was to go to two different salons. It wasn't the plan initially, but I went to one salon to like take out my braids, and they told me that they didn't do what I wanted to do, so I had to go to another salon. And by the time I was done taking out my braids in that salon, the other salon that we typically do the whole setting and rolling of my hair and all that stuff, they had closed, so I had to just wash my hair in the salon I took out my braids. Anyway, that's not why I brought out this camera now to talk to you guys. I'm about to be the most vulnerable I have been this year on this channel, I think anywhere at all this year, but let's do it. So you guys, I have been very careless about a lot of things in my life lately. I don't mean careless as the word together, I mean I have been caring very little about a lot of things in my life. I was doing a little bit of like reflecting, and I realized that it all stemmed from the fact that I don't know what's gonna happen after Housejob. I don't know the next stage of my life. I don't know what I'm gonna do after Housejob. Like, I don't know if, obviously, I think I want to practice medicine, as in clinical medicine. I want to do that. That is not the part that is in question. I don't even know if I want to continue with medicine. Let's even start from there. But if I'm continuing with medicine, I know it's clinical medicine. I don't know if my life is supposed to take a different route or different path after Housejob. There are a lot of uncertainties, and it scares me. I'm not even going to lie. It is very, very scary. And sometimes you look at people, maybe people in your field or maybe your friends, and you feel like you just can't help but ask, how do you know what you're supposed to be doing? And I know that a lot of people might even be facing this, what I'm currently facing right now. A lot of people are very confused on like what's next, you know, the next phase and the next stage. But someone once told me that everything is packaging. Everyone is confused, maybe not as confused as the other person is, but there is a whole lot of uncertainty after a Housejob, and everybody is just packaging, and everybody is just acting like they know what they're doing or they know what's next, you know, without saying it. Just look at them and like, oh my god, I feel like this person knows what next. Because anyway, that is what has been happening currently, and I feel like this has been affecting other parts of my life. I mean, for example, I just started my business again for the first time this year, the beginning of March. Okay, that's when I started my business again, or I opened my business this year. I did a little something, I think, in February. Am I sure now? I think I did a little something in February, but I wouldn't really count that. It has really taken a toll on other parts of my life. And we're going to be ending Q1 very soon, by the end of March. What I like to do is every month, actually, and every quarter, is I check my vision board and I check out for the things that I said I want to accomplish, and I see how far I have come to getting that thing done. There's some things that doesn't take time, there's some things that takes time. So I look at my vision board and I'm like, oh my god, I am nowhere near some of the things that I have written down that I was going to accomplish this year. And I like to see improvement every quarter, every month, if possible every week, depending on what the goal is, right? I know that there are some things that has happened in Q1 that I actually never planned for. Like, they just happened. Like, I know it was supposed to happen this year, but I never really like congested my Q1. I didn't want, oh my god, I want my entire life to change in Q1. I want to achieve all my vision board in Q1. That's not what I did. I wanted to really ease into the year. Like, January, I didn't really bombard January like that, but a lot of things actually happened in January that I was shook. Okay, so February, the same thing. March has been a bit slow, but just in the middle of March, I don't know why I just said March has been a bit slow, but March has been a bit slow, not just in the number of days, but also in like activities, in like accomplishing stuff and getting stuff done. March has been slow. I feel a bit somehow that I am just here pouring out and telling you guys all these things because I don't know. I really don't know why I am telling you guys all these things. If this part enters this vlog, I don't know who put it there. Because I'm being very vulnerable and I really don't like being vulnerable. I don't want becoming that girl. Basically, I'm going to be recording my journey to becoming that girl. That girl is not the girl that you see on social media. It's not that girl that is reading all over social media. That girl basically is being the girl that God designed me to be, accomplishing everything I am supposed to accomplish, you know, fulfilling my vision board for the year. Because I didn't create that vision board by myself, for myself alone. Okay, I created it for myself, but no, I didn't create it by myself. Okay, so I want to do that. It's going to be a mixture of like vlogs and maybe sit down videos where we just sit down and chat and just talk about the journey so far. It's not going to be a weekly thing. Let's see how it goes though. But I'm thinking about it. I don't have the full picture in my head, but I feel like it's not going to be a weekly thing. It's going to be like once every 2 weeks, or I don't know, every week. I really don't know, but it's either going to be up on Wednesdays or Fridays. Yep, so the first episode is going to probably come up after this vlog. Yeah. Yes, it's going to either be a Wednesday or Friday kind of post, because Sundays are like my typical regular vlogs. Maybe I can do Wednesday. Yeah, I can do Wednesday, then I can leave Fridays for like other kind of contents that I post. So yeah, if you're like me and if you're in that space where you're kind of confused, you don't know what's next for you, if you're in your 20s, if you're in your teenage years, if you're in your 30s, whatever it is, and you really want to find yourself, you want to find yourself and you want to discover what it is you're supposed to be doing, you can join me on this journey. It's not a challenge per se, but it's a challenge. So my goal is by the end of Q2, the second quarter of the year, that's by the end of June, I should have done some things that, I don't know why this microphone wants to leave my hand, I should have done some things that I said I was going to do. And I feel like June is also a good time for me because June is my birth month, so I feel like it's also a good time for me to, you know, put that timeline there. I'm not saying I'm going to achieve everything I said I'm going to accomplish this year by June. I'm just saying that most of it should have been done and I should definitely be a better person. I'm also not saying that by the end of June I should know what I want to do with my medical career. I'm just saying that I should be satisfied, content with my journey and where I am at the moment. So we have a new series, guys. We have a new kind of content on this channel. I pray to God that I be consistent with this. So yeah guys, this is the end of the video. I hope you found this video interesting one way or the other. I hope you learned a thing or two from this video. Kindly subscribe to the channel and click the notification bell so you can get notified when I have new videos on this channel, and also when I start the new series Becoming Her. And also like this video, please. Thank you very much. It's going to help me know that you enjoyed the video, and it's also going to help with the engagement. So please like this video and leave your comments below. I would really like to know what you think, and also share this video to your friends and family. This is the last post stop in this particular video, and I'll see you guys in my next one. I love you guys as always. Keep being amazing. Bye. Cannot convince me he's not-